Hello and welcome once again, students. In this course today, I am going to tell you how you can run your first test case on Mac machine. I have already showed you how you can download and install the test project agent in your Mac machine. Now, in this tutorial, I am going to tell you how you can execute the test case in a Mac machine. And when you are going to execute the test case in a Mac machine, you will encounter an error from Safari when you are executing for the first time. I will also tell you in this video how you can get resolved with that error and move forward to make the execution smooth and running. So let's start the tutorial and I will show you about how we can execute and fix the error in Safari and also run smoothly the test cases written in the test project automation tool on Mac machines. So in this video, I am going to use the same test case that I have written for my Windows machine. The same test case I am going to execute on a Mac machine. So practically this is a cross-platform testing and also a cross-browser testing. If you can remember, we have executed the test cases in Windows, Chrome and Firefox, and now I am going to execute in Mac Safari. So practically it is a cross-platform and cross-browser testing both. This is the test case which I have and I'm going to run this test case. To run this test case, first what I will need to do is that we will click on the run button, and before going to the run button, let us first check whether the agent is running or not. So I will go to agents and say that the agent is disconnected, so it will not run. So I have to switch on the agent. To switch on the agent, go to the test project in agent and double click on it. Once you double click on the test project agent, see a pop-up will come. It is saying that agent is running. So once your agent is running, in the manage agent console, you can see that the agent will be in a ready state. So we have to wait for the agent to be ready. Now you can see that the agent is in ready state and now we can execute the test cases. I will go to the project. Once I click on the project, it will take me inside the test steps. I will skip it from there and I will just click on the run button. Once I have clicked on the run button, I have a lot of options coming out from the Sayantan's Mac agent. The list of browsers are coming out, whether it will be a headless or not. I will go for Safari and I will click on start. Once, if you are executing in the Safari for the first time, you will get an error. I will also show you how you can fix this error. So let me take you the process of getting that error first so that you can understand what is the error and how you can resolve it. If you go in the monitor section, we can see that the agent is running. Okay, so it has completed the execution and it has the error. So let me go to the error part. What the error? The red one is the error. So I will go to the section and you can see that clearly it is saying that we have an error, could not create a session. You must enable the allow remote automation options in Safari developer menu to control Safari via web driver. That means now we have to allow the remote automation option in the Safari developers console so that the web driver or the session can be started. So let me tell you how you can allow the remote automation in Safari. To allow the remote automation in Safari, first you have to open the Safari browser and click on Safari. Okay, in the menu click on Safari. Once you click on Safari, you have a drop down menu where we have to click on preferences. Click on preferences, and once you are on a preference page, click on advanced. Once you click on advanced, you have an option to check and uncheck, which is show develop menu in menu bar. Click on show develop menu in menu bar. Once you click on show develop menu, you can see that develop option is coming in the main menu. Okay. If you uncheck it, you can see that there is no develop option. Once you can click it, you can see that a new menu is appearing
which is develop. So remain it checked and cross the pop menu. Once you click on develop, a lot of menu option is coming, from where you have to go straight down and click on allow remote automation. Once you click on allow remote automation, the web driver will now able to start the session in Safari. So click on allow remote automation. Just double check. Yes, it is checked. And now it will allow the remote automation or Safari to control the now it will allow the web driver to control Safari for its automation purpose. So this is how you have to allow the remote automation for the first time when you are running on Safari.
Once we are enable the remote automation in the Safari developer menu, we will now run once again. We will go to the same Safari browser from the Max agent and we will hit on start. Once we are done, we can see that the Safari browser has been popped up and all the execution step execution is running. Now the test step has been passed and we will directly go to the reports to check whether all the test steps has been clearly passed or not. Now we can see that the execution is complete and that all are green. That means the test step has passed and we are good to go. So in this way we will handle the Safari execution error in Max agent and Mac machine practically, and also in this video you have learned how to run your first test case in Mac. Bye bye for today and enjoy a lot of more videos from Test Project Automation